Well, do you have some things around the house that could be donated to the Indianapolis Museum of Art? If so, it could be used in a really cool exhibit. Nicole Masipsic is live at the IMA with more on that. Good morning.
Good morning, Julia. I love this opportunity. If you have books around your house, you can donate them to the Indianapolis Museum of Art, and it could actually become a piece of artwork that's going to be constructed right here in the lobby. But before that happens, the IMA needs your books to be donated. And to talk to us about what exactly they're looking for is Stephanie Perry with the IMA. Stephanie, this is such a really neat project.
Yeah, it's really cool. We're doing this in partnership with Indy Reads Books, and we're asking for everyone's books so that we can make this great piece of artwork.
So what is this going to look like? We have an actual picture of what the artist has created before, and this is kind of what it may look like here.
It's similar. It's going to be the same size and shape as one that was in Istanbul, but pretty rare. There's only two of them, and it's going to be on the ceiling, so you'll get to see books suspended.
And that's going to be right when you walk into the lobby of the IMA.
Oh, yes, right ahead, starting September 25th.
Now, before then, we need books to be donated by September 8th. So what kind of books are we looking for?
All sorts of books, hardback, softcover, just no magazines, no books with mud or bugs or mold or anything that's damaged like that.
And we're looking for any type of book. We have a variety of books behind us. There's everything from Angela's Ashes to The Color Purple to cookbooks.
Oh, yes, everything. So any kind of book that you want to donate. And when you're here, you can also vote on your favorite genre and tell us the kind of books that you like when you visit.
Now, something that's going to happen when you come to visit is you get to guess how many books are going to be used.
You do. So if you get it right, you get to win a prize. But you'll have to guess if we're talking 50, a couple hundred. So.
And we're collaborating with local art students, too.
We are. We have four Heron students that will help the artist actually assemble this work.
All right, we'll collect those books, bring them down to the IMA, and then when that exhibit opens on the 25th of September, you can look up and see if your book is there. Now, our director, John Momberg, gave me this fabulous book, Go Hang a Salami, I'm a Lasagna Hog. I know that doesn't make any sense, but it's a palindrome. So, if you see this book hanging up, I hope I do, it should be easy to spot, you'll know that it was one that was donated to. Back to you.
All right. I love that, Nicole. Thanks so very much. And, you know, wonder if it's becoming such an artsy thing because people are reading books on their
Kindles
digital,
anymore.
Their iPads, yeah. And their...
Yeah. And I still like to do this.